Hello and welcome to my Volvo with the Lamborghini engine project. Right, now it's time to weld the block here. I've been a little bit nervous about this one. Been cleaning out the surfaces here. I'm gonna install the pieces and bolt the block together here with the bolts and do some grinding. Start off some grinding of the cracks here. I think I need to go half this distance, so it will be all crack removed and filled with the weld here. It's all welded up on the backside here of the block. Now I have the inside here. I had some tack welds here on the inside when I was welding. Now I have removed this, some other new tack welds here, and I'm grinding this crack so I get rid of all of the crack. You can see here the holes goes into the bolt hole here, a little bit here into the oil hole. So yeah. Crack is almost gone there, a little bit more of grinding, and then I will start welding from the inside here. Just filled up the inside here, and yeah, I think it actually is a little better than I thought to weld this block. Pretty high current on this one, and I did put a little bit higher frequency. It hurts to make a little bit more cleaning action. So now I think I have to grind this a little bit to make it smooth. See if I have any imperfections in the welds, and so I will fill them up. Pretty happy with the results so far. Here is also the main bearing girdle, if you can call that. I'm not exactly sure what you say in English, the main bearings here. And you can maybe see here is one crack, and there's one crack on this side as well. I will grind them out and weld them. And here you can see the main caps, that they are in steel, but everything else here is aluminum. And if we check on the other side, we can actually see the steel part here. Yeah, so the main caps is actually just bolted steel, and the aluminum is just rounded here. Should be pretty strong, this one, if you don't crash with the car, with the backside into a wall. Some of the threads here was a little bit messed up. This one I was able to clean up, and this one as well. But here it's actually two bolts here for the main bearings. Here with the threads for this M8, this is M10 and this is M8, it's completely gone. So now I have drilled this up. I've used this main bearings here to drill it straight, and then I'm gonna put in some thread inserts. And I did not want to have helicoils. I want to have like inserts like these. And then I used this Wirt. It's very expensive, this kit, but it's very good actually. And in this kit, first we have a drill with the correct size. After that we use this. It's like a little mill here, So get this little step there. Then we have this tap, normal tap. And the last, the installation tool, it's a little bit special. Looks like this. So next step now, tap this hole. The threads are cleaned out, and some oil on the installation tool here. Let's see. This tool actually puts the insert in place, and when it is in place, it expands the threads, so it will hold its position in there. Goes a little bit heavy, and then it should go light again. Yeah, now it's light again. So now the time start thread bushing is installed. Okay, it's time to take the NU block to the machine shop and see if it's possible to machine it, if it is straight here or not. Engine block is back from machine shop, but it's not machined. Nothing is done really. They did some measurements, and what have happened when I welded all this, all got hot, everything moved down. So also this upper part moved down. Maybe I could prevent this with some, putting like an axle through here or something when welding. But didn't do it. So my plan now is to weld here, put more material all the way around here, this bearing, and up here. Then I'm gonna see if I can find someone that can machine this surface and not take away any material at all, almost. Maybe in hundreds or a couple of hundreds of a millimeter on this one and on this one. So let's weld again. Right, now I have welded on about a millimeter of material here and here and all the way in this bearing here. I'm here at Total Innovation in Sweden, and very nice company here that have a lot of CNC machines. Very nice workshop here, making parts for many of the big companies, many advanced parts. And I have my friend Christian here helping me out with the engine block. Engine block is inside here now, facing off. So let's see if we can save this block. Made some blocks here to put under the block. I'm putting the block here in the machine, and we put some shims underneath here to make it level. We have the engine block now in this three-axis CNC. It's an Hyundai machine. We're trying to level it. Setting up to zero. Yeah, we have the part here. This is the engine block, or the face of that one. So now we have the G code that is going into the CNC machine. Pretty simple and quick job. This is the one we're gonna use. Face it off. Measure in the tool. Ah, wisst. Okay, I think the final cut is done. And yeah, looking good even here. Here is where I welded. This one is still a little bit low, but that's no problem because this is a crankcase on both sides here. So should have been putting more weld in here, but that's fine. And the surface finish, it is very nice. Okay, now we manually take a little bit off this main bearing, the lower part. It was 35 thousandths too high, so we lowered it from from zero. 35 thousandths of a millimeter. Checking the girdle now, and yeah, it is within 100 millimeter. Very good. Flat blade running here, Hyundai, yeah, and they also do the WRC rally cars, so it's a cool company. They make a lot of nice parts here, advanced parts. This is a spindle for a hot rod, actually. Mostly parts for the big industries in Sweden. Some EDM machines, a couple of 3-axis machines. Some lathes. This is actually the 9-axis machine that made the axle for my centering of the gearbox. Dark today. It's actually Saturday today, so yeah, it's not full production today. Tool shop. They have a couple of 3-axis and a couple of 5-axis machines as well. All Hyundais. Another 5-axis back there. Thank you so much, guys, here at Total Innovation for making this engine block. Usually they do more advanced parts like this, but... Okay, head home. And by the way, 245er here. I was hoping for a winter here in Sweden with some snow, but the weather in Sweden, it's terrible this year. Not been this bad for many years. I just removed the oil pan from the engine here. Here we have very nice and fresh oil pan. And I actually sold this one. New price for this one is $2,500, $3,000, I think. Here we have the bearing housing for the four-wheel drive that's water inside it. I have a car here. It's a Gallardo that had the bearing failure of that four-wheel drive bearing. So the oil pan was broken. So to make some money for the Volvo here, I sold it and I got the broken one as an exchange. So I will weld it up and maybe cut this off and put a hose instead of this water line, because I will not use the four-wheel drive in the Volvo, of course. So one way to make a little bit money and fix the Gallardo here for a little better price. I removed the oil pan very easily without removing gearbox and stuff, but this engine is now only bolted with some couple of bolts. Usually we have to remove the gearbox and everything. That's why when this one now replacing oil pan, you have to remove the engine, because there is some bolts here, yeah, you can see behind the clutch there, so to access it. So not so easy as many other cars that, where you can remove the oil pan with the engine inside the car. Lamborghini, no. The car is back on the lift
And I will do some engine mounts. Actually started with some mounts here on the engine, some steel plates here, and on this one, some steps here in this one. And it's just normal steel I found under here I had. So no fancy stuff, should have been aluminum maybe, but to save some time, I do it in steel for now. I can use the normal MIG welder to do the mounts there. I actually modified the front beam once again, and I want to have the engine as far back as possible because of the steering column down there collides with the oil pump. And actually the axle from the steering wheel was hitting the cylinder head here, so I removed it. And here it is, just modified it a little bit, cut it off, we'll cut it more, and then I will do some linkage so the steering axle will go a little bit lower there. Let's see a little bit of the mess inside the car. A lot of wires, and you can actually see the engine here with the cover. And I actually did some modification with a big hammer to make it go further back. It will need a little bit more modifications. The cam gear cover hits the firewall there. I'm also doing a little upgrade on the brakes here. These are the stock ones, 260 millimeters. Yeah, it's actually the turbo ones, not the stock one from this car, but the calipers, four pistons, steel ones, working pretty good, but actually very underrated brakes for the when I had the Supra engine in this one. Now it's 320 millimeter brakes and these aluminum four piston calipers here. They're actually pretty lightweight. It's Brembo style. It's actually like Volvo V70R, S60R brakes. These are knockoffs, copies. Hopefully they will still work good. I usually do not like China parts. I don't know if these are made in China, but these ones look pretty good, so we will try them. Very good price for them. Actually, I bought adapters here also, so they bolt on directly to the 240. They are from ASS, Andreasson Steel and Speed here in Sweden. Compared to the brakes of this one, Subaru Impreza, STI, WRC, that has this Brembo brakes here, we can see. Yeah, they are actually looking, the casting looks pretty much the same. And the size is the same, so should be good brakes. One bummer though is the offsets of the disc brakes and the calipers here is not really good for my rims here, my steel rims. So I need to put spacers on, or if I can find another disc brake and move the caliper a little bit further in here. The rims, by the way, have several people asking. They are Peugeot 406 17 inch rims, and I have replaced, I have changed the offset of these ones. Maybe you can see here the old welds. So the center here on the inside is welded. I just grinded off the welds and then moved the center inner and then welded on again. Don't know if I even put some paint on there or not, but so the offset is correct for the Volvo. And also it looks a little bit better with a little bit dish there. About the engine mounts, I'm not sure what is going to fit on the sides here with the headers and steering, oil pump and hoses. So I waited a little bit with the mounts and did some mounts here in the front of the engine instead, welded directly into the chassis. So this is a little bit temporary only, so I can have the engine in the correct position and build yeah, headers and stuff around it. And then we'll see what kind of engine mounts will fit. Maybe I can do mounts here in the front, because here I have some space, and do it with some kind of rubber mounts there, so it will not be fixed like it is now. All right, thanks for watching. Next video, maybe with my Lamborghini.